Hello guys and welcome to Vlogging Project. Today we're gonna have a look at the Youcool V11, a small phone with a big battery, and judging by its ergonomics, it's made for inmates. And before you ask yourself why this guy has a Moncler inside his house, well, because of that. 40 degrees, that man's not hot. So let's waste no more time and let's get the review done, shall we?
Now, the only reason that they bought this phone initially is that that's the only phone in the market right now which fits inside my ashtray like that.
Okay guys, so let's start with a quick unboxing over here. What we can see on the box is we are not creative, we are beyond creative. Okay, if you say so. So at the back of the box, let's see what we've got. Youcool V11 Digital Candy Bar Phone. Easy life, easy use, all in easy phone Youcool series. Blah blah blah. So basically the main thing about this phone is the huge battery. 1440 milliamperes of battery. It's got MP3, FM radio, MP4, camera and Bluetooth. And basically let's see what we have in the box inside. There's the phone itself. What else do we have? We've got a cable, instruction manuals and a headset. That's very rare guys, especially for a phone which costs about £19. And something very important guys. Micro USB plus 3.5mm jack, don't forget that. So what do we have here is a small little phone compared to the Nokia 3310. As you can see, it's a little bit taller, but definitely is a lot narrower. So it's gonna be very easy for your friends in prison to stick it down there. Yeah, you know what I mean. So let's have a look. I'm gonna file this on the side here. So let's see what we have. The back is made of plastic. It's nice though. It's I've got a pink version because I like pink stuff. And what does it say on the camera? Let's see. So it says megapixel on the camera. I'm really not sure if they could find any smaller camera than this one, but it doesn't really matter. And design wise, let me tell you that this phone actually feels nice in the hand. The front over here is made of metal, kind of a brush metal, and it's really nice. The buttons are really big, you know, and clicky. I really like the buttons, guys, and the overall design is very nice. So basically, if you want to check the clock, you just press the power button once, it shows you the clock. That's how you switch off the screen. If you want to unlock it, you press over here, you press over here. That's it, a little bit of a, you know, Nokia style. And now let's have a look at the menu. We've got, you know, call logs, contacts, messages, settings, multimedia tools, profiles, my files. So yeah, but before that, actually before, let's have a look under the hood. Let's have a look under the hood, guys. Let's see what we have. Check this one out, guys. Have you seen this big of a battery in this mobile phone? You have on the right. So one SIM, second SIM and micro SD over here. Really nice, really nice. Now something very interesting, when you have your screen on like that and when you remove the back cover, check this out guys. This light over here between the battery and the frame is coming from the screen. So basically don't get this phone wet please, because it's not gonna end up well. So let's put this phone back together. And let's see what's going on. Yeah, I'm gonna switch it back on. Let me know what the melody. Listen, Samsung, ring the bell. Okay, so now let's have a look at, you know, multimedia. What do we have here? Camera, audio, video, FM radio, recorder. So can you imagine making a video with this phone? Anyway, let's see how the camera is. The camera is, let's see how the camera is. Well, the camera is, pathetic. But anyway, there is a camera. That's what's important. There is a camera. Now, let's have a look at tools. We've got internet. Can you imagine checking your Facebook on this thing? Calendar, calculator, ebook, alarm, Virgin. It has Virgins as well. Beauty phone. That's Bluetooth. So basically, let's see how the multimedia is. Audio. Let's play something. Let's play something quickly. Let's see. Bloody hell. Yeah, I mean, the phone is nice and loud. The speaker is over here. But let me tell you that for conversation, this speaker is bullshit. It's really, really not good, guys. And about the battery life, from this big of a battery, you can expect somewhere about a week of battery with both SIM cards, which is great. But the thing is that, yes, the phone's got Bluetooth. But the problem over here is that it keeps disconnecting from my car. Connects, disconnects, like that all the time. So I can't really use the Bluetooth function anyway. But I guess in jail, you're not going to use the Bluetooth function. So, yeah. And the other thing is that the build quality is a little bit questionable. So I've dropped the phone once. Let me zoom in the camera and see. Can you see this little nick over here? So this little nick caused a little bit of a problems to me. Now check this one. Look at the screen. Check it out now. It's a little bit on the left side. Actually, let me centralize it like that. Check this out. Now it's straight. Now it's on the left. Now it's back on straight. So basically the build quality is very questionable of this phone, guys. But I guess if you're looking for the exact same size to stick it into somebody's bum, I guess that's the right phone to get, guys. So get your drones ready and send this to your friends and mates. That's about it, guys. No, seriously, I don't recommend getting this phone. 20 quid is way too much for that crap. And basically, you're better off with the Nokia 3310. If you haven't watched my review, please do. I did a water test and everything else, and the phone still works. So, yeah, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope that was entertaining in some weird way. And, yeah, see you later.